comrades, welcome back to Commander Brito Raskiski. And comrades, today we are going to be talking about what the fucking strikes in India are happening, comrades. Now before we begin, comrades, the person who basically wrote this script for me, comrades, and everything I'm about to say is Yapish Tukral, comrades. Here is his channel, comrades, it's going to be in the description, comrades, and in the pinned comment, comrades. Make sure to go check him out, comrades. He actually makes really good videos. I watched a bit of them, comrades, a couple of days ago, comrades. They're very good. Make sure to go check him out, and he helped me so much with his video, comrades. He so much, comrades. And now let's talk about Indian strikes.
What was the strike?
Comrades, if you don't know where India is, comrades, on the world map, comrades, you are just... Comrades, you are stupid. India is one of the most recognized countries, comrades. It is where? In Southern Asia, comrades. And it is the second most populated country in the world, comrades. And recently, comrades, a new law has been passed that has affected farmers in many ways, comrades. And it has made more freedom, as India says, comrades. But as we're gonna see soon, the farmers do not see this as good, comrades. The act, obviously, comrades, the new law they're passing, comrades, is meant to make the farmers be able to hold their own production, comrades. Do what the fuck they want, comrades. But it is really not that way, comrades, and it seems that these farmers, they're actually being impacted worse, comrades, by this shit.
Why farmers are angry?
Comrades, on paper, this seems really good. When you think about, comrades, wow, the farmers, they get to sell wherever they want, comrades. They get to sell whatever they want, how much they want, comrades. They get to do anything they really want, comrades. Yes, comrades, I get to do everything I want. But then, comrades, we begin to see the fact that Indian farmers, they're struggling, comrades. They don't know how their money is going to be regulated properly, comrades. Will it be given out normally, comrades? Will it not? Will the government lie to them, comrades? We don't really know yet, comrades. You can't trust a capitalist government, I'm telling you, comrades. Look at shit like America, comrades. America, bullshit country. Pakistan, comrades, bullshit country. Britain, bullshit country. Comrades, name me a country. Bullshit country. Comrades, if any of you said Russia, I will beat the shit out of you. But anyway, comrades, obviously, comrades, you also see money will not be regulated, might not be regulated properly, comrades. Also, comrades, you look at bigger companies. They have more leverage, comrades. You know, because of capitalism, big companies, they are big and they're like, well, comrade, look at this small bitch. He is gonna be my bitch, comrades. And Indian farmers, they might have to abide by the company's rules. Oh. Wow, comrades, I really don't want this shit. Comrades, most of the protests are happening in these states. Uttar Pradesh, Punjab and Haryana. Comrades, if I pronounce Haryana wrong, I am very sorry. Not really, comrades. I do not apologize to people. Now, comrades, comrades, they are obviously very sad, obviously, comrades. Prices might go down, comrades, obviously, the minimum starting prices, comrades. And if you don't know what any of that shit means, comrades, because you're not an economic genius like me, comrades. I know my shit about economics, comrades. It means money goes down, comrades, and Indian farmers could be poor, comrades. They will not know shit, comrades. They will be like, oh, well, comrades, I have no money. My family's gonna die. Sorry, comrades, I got a bit too much into character, comrades. I'm about to start crying in a second. Now, comrades, if you actually look at the data, comrades, that was presented to me by Yapish, comrades, or Japish. I didn't ask, comrades, but I pronounced it Yapish, okay? Kapish? Oh, comrades, I am very funny, aren't I? Yes, comrades, why are most of the protests in Uttar Pradesh, Punjab and Haryana? Well, comrades, it is mostly because these areas, comrades, they are the ones that are benefited the most, comrades. Now, as I said before, state-run areas were better off than the non-state-run areas, comrades. Which is why we see, you know, protests happening, and many of these protests did involve communism, comrades. But we'll get to that in a second. But yes, comrades, these areas benefited more, so the people, the Indian farmers, comrades, they're fed up. Comrades, they do not want this shit. I do not want this shit!
How communism will be affected?
Comrades, with the next bit, my friend Yapish put in the Word document that this might not be true. This might be a bit, you know, lots of maybe bullshit, comrades, so take this with a pinch of salt, okay, comrades? If you don't, you're fucking retarded, comrades. Well, comrades, lately in the protests, as you can see by these pictures, comrades, lots of Indians have been supporting the Indian Communist Party, comrades, and it's a beautiful sight, comrades. I love these pictures, very good pictures, comrades. Now, obviously, comrades, when you actually think about it, because of India's population, the Indian Communist Party is one of the biggest parties in world history, comrades. Similar to size in the Bolshevik Party, comrades, mainly because there's so many people in India, so even if like 10% of Indians voted, that's 130 million people, comrades. That is like, Comrades, that is like two Englands, comrades. England, you're a pussy hole. You're shit, comrades. Fucking shit, comrades. But yes, obviously, comrades, if you really look at it, comrades, if they are supporting communism. Now, why are they supporting this? Well, comrades, they look at it and they're like, well, comrades, this is a far better economic system and really helps us a lot more with our economic situation, comrades, than this capitalist non-state run system, comrades, where bigger companies are pushing us around, comrades, and they're not letting us do shit. Now, comrades, this is also very good for communism, as these protests are very peaceful, comrades, and it paints communism in a very good light, comrades, which, you know, many of our communist times don't show very good, comrades. Spartacist uprising in Germany, comrades, 1920s. Comrades, a disgrace to communism. If I'm 100% serious, comrades, I do not want to be associated with the Spartacists. Spit on you, bitches. Now, comrades, my friend Yapisha has written a little skit for me. Now, comrades, I do most of my skits by myself, so we're gonna see how this skit goes. Comrade, wow! This hammer and sickle! This kinda looks like the shit we do our shit with, comrades. As farmers, we make shit with hammer and sickle, wow. Is this our new flag? What is this shit? Oh, comrade, I think this is the new leading party. Comrades, wow. I didn't really know about communism before, comrades, but it seems like this is the right way to go. Many farmers who didn't actually know about communism just interpreted the flag as their new flag, comrades, or the flag of the protest, comrades, which is helping the protest spread even more around the country, which is very good to see.
Will India be communist?
No. Comrades, India is not going to become communist. Let's be 100% serious here. As much as I would love India to become a communist superpower, comrades, it is not going to. Now, comrades, however, this is not saying that it's not going to become socialist. Now, comrades, obviously, before the newer times of India, comrades, India was socialist, comrades, and it was still a thriving economy, comrades. So, you know, we're beginning to see some shit where India might go back into socialism, comrades, being more of a United Kingdom, comrades, type of country instead of a America type of country, which is very good to see India. You're making steps in the right direction. I can appreciate that a lot, comrades. So it's going to be interesting to see how maybe even the next Indian elections go, comrades, and what's going to happen with them. But anyway, comrades, thank you for watching this video. Now, comrades, I would like to thank Yapish Tukral, comrades. Go subscribe to his channel for helping me write this whole script, comrades. I had really no idea what was going on with this situation, comrades, so he did help me a lot. Now, comrades, make sure to subscribe. Go watch the documentary that I just made, comrades, and make sure to let communism strike again.